The One and Only Ivan, which was based on the novel by Catherine Applegate, tells the story of Ivan the gorilla, who spent several decades at a shopping mall before being moved to a more natural habitat at a zoo. Applegate's novel was inspired by a real-life gorilla named Ivan, who spent 27 years living in an enclosure at the B&I Circus Store in Tacoma, Washington. In the movie, Ivan has distant memories of living in the Congo as an infant, and he longs for that freedom once again. The One and Only Ivan's ending finds him sharing a tender goodbye with his owner, Mac, before being moved to a more natural and wide-open habitat at a zoo. He's released into the outdoors, and the music swells as he takes it all in. Finally, surrounded by the other gorillas and animals, he's truly happy. In this video, we're going to explain how the real-life ending wasn't quite as picture-perfect. After spending 27 years in his caged enclosure at the B&I Circus Store, Ivan in many ways had become institutionalized. This is somewhat similar to an inmate who spent several decades behind bars and upon his release struggles to adjust to life on the outside. Unlike the movie, the real Ivan the Gorilla's cage was somewhat more confining, although there were different sections. The enclosure and his human caretakers encompassed most of what he knew. After several years of protests over Ivan's confinement, along with dwindling sales and a bankruptcy filing, the B&I store decided to donate Ivan to the Woodland Park Zoo in Seattle in 1994. However, the zoo's gorilla habitat was full, and they placed him on permanent loan to Zoo Atlanta in Atlanta, Georgia. Much like Bryan Cranston's character in the movie, the owners of the B&I store were indeed heartbroken when they had to separate with Ivan. After arriving at Zoo Atlanta, it took several months of adjustment before Ivan was exposed to the zoo's outdoor habitat named the Ford African Rainforest. In the spring of 1995, he took his first steps into the grass and trees of the open outdoor habitat. It was the first time he had been in the open outdoors in 27 years, and that year marked the first time he had been around other gorillas in approximately 30 years. The outdoors were foreign to him, and he preferred to stay in his indoor enclosure at the zoo when it was cold or raining. One of his primary caretakers at the zoo, Jody Kerrigan, stated that even when there was dew on the grass, he would try to avoid walking on it. To help him avoid the wet grass and get where he wanted to go, Kerrigan came up with the idea of giving Ivan burlap sacks of coffee beans. He would place a sack in front of him and step on it, then reach behind him and repeat the process, eventually getting where he wanted to go. His aversion to being cold and or wet was the result of having spent years in a dry, temperature-controlled enclosure. Another goal with Ivan was that he be able to socialize with the other gorillas at Zoo Atlanta. Over the years, he got to be around several of the female gorillas at the zoo, including Molly, Coochie, Shamba, Kashada, and Kinyani. He was once observed mating with Kinyani, but never sired any offspring. Despite being around these other gorillas, Ivan was never able to develop strong social connections with them. Much like at the B&I store, his strongest social ties were always with his human caretakers. As a result of his upbringing, Ivan still had a lot of human qualities. While at Zoo Atlanta, he continued painting. He was the only gorilla that could hold the canvas without ripping it to shreds. Ivan lived out the final 18 years of his life at Zoo Atlanta. He died on August 20th, 2012, while under anesthesia during a medical exam. He died at age 50, which is almost 2 decades longer than the average lifespan of a silverback. Prior to his death, his health had been in decline, and an autopsy would reveal a large tumor in his chest. I don't think many people would argue that Ivan would have been better off staying in his enclosure at the B&I store, but as you can see, he never fully adjusted to his new environment. And there are certainly those who admired Ivan at the zoo, but at the same time, wondered how much better his life would have been if he had never been captured at all. I hope this gave you some insight into the one and only Ivan's ending in relation to the true story of Ivan the Gorilla. If you want to learn more about the one and only Ivan's historical accuracy, check out our related video or read our article over on historyvershollywood.com. That's linked in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and be sure to subscribe to our channel. Anchors away, my friends.